My name is Ezra, and I find broken down classic cars and upcycle them into low maintenance electric rides.
First I find it.
The engine is extra.
Inspect it. Buy it.
Deal.
All right. Part it out, and then take it to Hutchinson Electric to have it converted to an electric vehicle.
Thanks. I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you.
My name is Nathan Hutchinson. I own Hutchinson Electric Auto Repair. I drive a 1971 VW Beetle, about 200 horsepower, no gas.
Street, first thing. We got this motor, this new bigger motor now. So I want you to take that adapter plate and make sure it all fits.
My name is Street Brown. The first electric car I ever built was with Nathan. And he really showed me some of the more technical side of things.
Emily, I want you to finish on these batteries. You got to finish soldering these little chips together.
I'm Emily Fleming. I'm here learning whatever they're willing to teach me. I like acquiring new skills and learning new things. I do comedy at night.
I was really, really into Lord of the Dance. Like, crazy into it. Something about a shirtless man who's only angry from the waist down is, like, awesome. I don't know what it is.
Dad, pay attention. I want you to figure out where you're going to put this charger along with the motor controller and all these other little components, because we got to make sure that it all fits in the car. So we'll end up with a 120-volt system, 400 amp, about 65, 70 kilowatts. End up with charge time less than 8 hours and a range of about 40, 50 miles.
Any car, any vehicle can be electric. You can have an electric boat, you can have an electric airplane, you can have an electric chopper if you want.
Okay, and when you tighten it, try not to move the adapter too
much. We get up in there and look at it.
Tighten it up. Mark it. You're good.
Charlie, never mind the last one. I think it's an important thing that we get off fossil fuel. And that's the point. Don't lose the point in all the egos and the bullshit.
Once converted, these low-maintenance vehicles cost a fraction of what it will cost to drive this with gasoline.
Let's take it out.
Ezra's project went really well, I think. There's always bumps in the road. There's always a lot of customization that we have to do to make certain things work.
It works!
I knew it would work.
I knew all along. I had faith.
I never doubted it.
Works.
It works!
Good enough for now.
Successful test. It's a computer car. Well, you know, it's retro-futuristic.
My dad first got me into cars.
It's fun for me. It's fun for me because I'm involved with my son.
You need a sign on there that says, if you're in here, you're really stupid. This is a summer car.
Hey, Ezra.
Hey, Nathan. How you doing?
Good.
Oh, looking good.
Here it is.
Cool. Danger, high voltage electricity. Awesome.
It's great. I think you're really going to love it.
So Nathan, the gauges are different. So have my speedometer.
The amp meter all the way on the left is basically telling you how much energy you're using. And that third gauge there gives you a lot of information about the batteries.
I was not expecting the car to be this smooth and this powerful. Nathan really has blown me away with this. I'm extremely impressed. Whoa, it stops. That's more important to me actually than going, the stopping part. So once the car is complete,
I'll end up with a vehicle that has zero emissions, has low fuel costs, and almost no maintenance.